Good morning. It's Monday, October 15th, and welcome to Bleed Green News. I'm Courtney LeBlanc.
And I'm Kaylin Menus Rash.
All CCHS students, there will be a Halloween dance on Saturday, October 20th from 7 to 9 p.m. in the CCHS cafeteria. Cost will be $5. Please wear our school-appropriate costumes.
CCHS Counseling Department encouraged all students and staff to fill out the Counseling Needs Assessment Google form that was sent to you in your school email. This information will be helpful in building our school culture and community.
Seniors' pictures and quotes are due by Friday, November 2nd. Please email them to Mrs. Mayer through your CCHS Google email.
Also, the senior ads are on sale 10% off the ad price if reserved by October 31st. You can reserve online at yearbookforever.com or pay in the office.
High school seniors planning to graduate in 2019 can apply now to attend WNC, Great Basin College, Truckee Meadows Community College, or College of Southern Nevada, free of tuition and class fees in fall of 2019. For more information, contact your guidance counselor or go to Community College website and search Promise. The deadline is October 31st.
The FFA chapter is selling cookie dough. One tub costs $20 and can make up to 40 cookies, plus it can be kept in the freezer for a year. There are several kinds to choose from. If you're interested, contact Ms. Johnston or any FFA member.
Tutoring will be available Mondays through Thursdays before school in room M10 from 7:30 to 8:05 a.m. and after school in room 16 from 3 o'clock to 4:30 p.m.
All CCHS students, you can order your yearbooks online at yearbookforever.com. The cost is $75 if you order before December 31st. After January 1st, the price goes up to $85.
The Strength of Nations Multicultural Club will be making dream catchers tomorrow in room M8.
Ian Beavers and Patrick Morales interviewed our new agriculture teacher. Let's check it out.
Ag science is a broad field. That's what I get to teach, and as well as biology. Ag science encompasses anything from your ag business related adventures to things with animals, communication, speaking skills, interviews, all of that different types of things. I primarily focus on the animal and plant size with some career readiness mixed in there. Ag science is important to CCH students as you drive around our Fallon community. You see alfalfa fields, you see lots of farming and stuff, so it helps them be more aware of their community as well as shows them how to be able to get involved and into different things as well. My education and background in ag science is I was involved in FFA and 4-H since I was in eighth grade. So I have been in the field of agriculture, showed livestock, planted plants, been involved in it since I was young, and that's what I decided to study in college at Great Basin. So I was able to study ag science in a variety of different ways. I decided to become an ag science teacher because I had a very strong mentor throughout my years in agriculture. He helped us build a farm from the bottom up, and it was just something that I'd never forget, and it's something I wanted to bring to other students' lives and be able to help and encourage them as well. FFA is the National FFA Organization. It's no longer Future Farmers of America. That was a change way long ago, but many don't know about. It's an organization where students get to compete in career development events, so they get to use the skills they've learned in the classroom as well as outside in their individual products and get to put their knowledge to use.
Thank you, Ian and Patrick, for that interview.
In sports, our boys varsity soccer team will be hosting Incline High School tomorrow at 4 p.m.
Also, our volleyball teams will also be hosting the Dayton Dust Devils tomorrow, starting with the freshman game at 4 o'clock, JV at 5 o'clock, and varsity at 6 o'clock. Good luck to all our teams.
That's all for today. Thank you for watching Bleed Green News.
I'm Courtney LeBlanc.
And I'm Kaylin Menus Rash.
Have a great day.